used to define pattern of different lexemes. So regular expression are like underscore is included among the letters. Like if letter underscore this letter underscore is established to be stand for any letter, or the underscore and digit underscore established to stand for any digit, then we could describe the language for C identifiers by letter underscore, then or the letter underscore. Letter here, the letter means you can understand it is speaking about A to Z and capital A to capital Z, and digit is 0 to 9. It is speaking about. Okay. Then the vertical bar is treated as union parenthesis group of group the sub expressions. You know, then star we have to zero or more occurrence to represent zero or more occurrence. Then juxtaposition of letter underscore which with the remainder of the expression signifies the concatenation. So these are the different thing we use to write regular expression. We use this vertical line to give union, or you can say or. Okay, then parenthesis we also use in the writing of regular expression. Then we also use star to represent repetition of the pattern, and juxtaposition is something called used for concatenation, signifies the concatenation. Each regular expression R denotes a language LR, okay, which is also defined recursively from the language denoted by R's sub expression. Understand? So if you have a regular expression R, then you are basically having a language L of R. Okay, that means a language defined by the regular expression R. Okay, so when you these are basically the formal languages you are speaking about, the small languages, right? So say you have R1, R2, R3, the small languages. That means you have three small languages, L1, L2, and L3. Okay, now for a particular task, you may need to union of these three languages, and you may have L4 as L1 union, L2 union, L3. Understand? So don't panic by looking at this R. This R is denotes the language. Oh my God, this small R is going to be denote a full language. So it can be very complex. No, this R basically denotes a very, very, very small language. Okay. So don't panic by reading these words. Okay. You have to understand. Okay, but when we need a little bit big language, we just like to concatenate, or we just like to union of two small regular expression, okay, or these small languages together. Okay, now rules that define the regular expressions over some alphabet sigma and the language that those expressions denote. Okay, so rules that define the regular expressions over some alphabet sigma. So you already know we use sigma to represent alphabets and the language that those expression denotes. Okay, so basis, there is two rules. First is epsilon is a regular expression and language defined by epsilon is a empty language given by epsilon. Okay, only symbol is there, that is empty symbol. The language whose sole member is the empty string. So epsilon is known as empty string or empty symbol, it doesn't matter, right? As it is empty. If A is a symbol in the alphabet, then A is a regular expression. Understand? Now you can understand that how small it can be. The language with one string length one with A in its one position. That means if you have a regular expression R equal to, so given by only A, okay? R is simply a single A. Then we will say that, okay, we have a language defined by the regular expression R. And this language is having only one string, which is A. Understand? So this simple it is. Okay. Then there are four parts to induction whereby the larger regular expressions are built from the small one. That is what I was telling. That you never think about a complex large regular expression. You start thinking about the smaller ones. Okay, suppose R and S are regular expression denoting language LR and LS. So LR is say this one. Say we have S is another regular expression, this is only B. So a language defined by S will be look like this. So we have two regular expression, R and S. Okay? And we need in different situation we need different kind of combination of these two regular expression. So the ways to combining them is first one is here is regular expression is by union, by using union of R and S given by R vertical bar S is a regular expression denoting the language union. So if you do, this is called OR and this is called union. So this basic relation you have to understand. OR is nothing but OR is given by vertical bar which is corresponding to union in set given by U. Then see here, nothing is there. If there is nothing, it is called concatenation. Okay, so if sometimes this is given by dot also, okay, but here it is not there. So concatenation given by dot, okay, in the set also it is concatenation. Okay, then comes this asterisk. It is nothing but repetition of the expression. Okay, so there are nothing to remember in both the cases. It is asterisk only. Okay, so here asterisk used. Then R is regular expression denoting language LR. We already know there is nothing to discuss. Okay. So this last rule says that we add additional pair of parentheses around the expression without changing the language they denote. Okay, so why we use this additional parentheses in the both side of R? To just protect R from the mixing with the other part of when you are concatenating, when you are going for doing OR or union with other, so that it cannot be mixed up. Okay, so that the expression does the unique quality or the original quality of R or properties of R can be sustained. Okay, we may drop certain pair of parentheses like convention. What kind of things we can drop? The unity operator asterisk has the highest precedence and is left associative. Okay, this is something else we need to remember. Basically, what are the different operator we have already seen in our discussion of regular expression is asterisk, then we have seen dot, that is concatenation, then we have seen union operation, correct? So if I go with this is having, star is having the highest precedence here, okay? It is also called the unary operator, and it is definitely left associative. Okay, then comes the concatenation. This is have the second highest precedence, and this is also left associative. Then comes this union operation. The vertical bar has the lowest precedence. Okay, because you know this is union operation. Okay, and definitely this is also left associated. Okay, so if you have some expression after doing your required combination of different small languages, the three are here. A union in bracket B star C. It can be written as a simplified way, A or B star C. Okay. So both the expression denote the set of string that are either a single A or are zero or more B's followed by one C. Understand? So what does this mean? What we have, A or B star, okay, concatenated with C. So the appearance of these two, if you see here, A or B star is here, okay? That means either A can come here, or B star can come here. Both of them can't come together. If A comes, B star is omitted, then C will come. So AC is going to be a string from this language. B star comes, then star means the repetition of B zero to n number of times. So if it is zero times, then only C will come. If it is one time, then B, C will come. If it is two times, then B, B, C will come. Understand? So this is what is written. Now, let we have a alphabet A and B. Okay? The regular expression A or B denotes the language A comma B. That means if you have regular expression A or B, this regular expression, it can generate only two string, either A or B. So your language is going to be A or B, A, B, only two string you can generate. Okay, now if you just make it a little bit complex, or you want to generate more sentences by using this alphabet, you can do one thing. A or B, A or B, concatenation A or B, okay? That means it is nothing but say this is R, you are doing just R, concatenation R, okay? This is nothing but R, concatenation R, So it will start giving you AB. Then from the first part, if it is coming A, second part also it is coming A, then it is going to be A. On the first part, it is coming A. From the second part, it is giving B. Then it is going to be AB. And the same way, it can be BA and BB. Okay. So the language of all strings of length 2 over the alphabet epsilon. Another regular expression for the same language can be given as this. Okay. So this, see, this is the reason, you know, many times we say that regular expressions are not unique. One particular language can be represented by multiple regular expressions. Okay, so the same language can be represented by this regular expression and this regular expression. And basically, I think you have also faced this creates a problem between give exams. You write some regular expression like this and don't get marks. You have to understand, when you are writing as a regular expression, you try to reduce it to the smallest form it is possible. You just give an effort so that you can score the maximum marks by writing a regular expression. Okay. A asterisk denotes a language consisting of all string of zero or more A's. So, no, there is repetition of A's, zero to n number of A's. So if you give a regular expression R equal to A asterisk, it can generate strings like this. Okay, then A or B whole star, that means what? Parenthesis, and from the parenthesis you will choose either A or B. Then you repeat that how many times you want. So it will give you like epsilon A and so on, or it can also give you B and so on. Okay, so this is the set of string can be generated by this regular expression. So all the strings of A's and B's, that is what I'm told you. This is different from the previous one. So another regular expression for the same language can be given as A star, B star, whole star. Okay? Yeah, correct. So then, fifth, another regular expression is given. A or A star B denotes the language A. It can give only A because R sign is there. So from this side, only A can come. And if you take this side, then A star can be zero time repeated. So epsilon, and then only B can be generated. Okay. Or even if you take this part and this asterisk repeats A one time, then it will give you AB. This asterisk repeats two times, it will give you AAB and so on. Okay. Now a string A and all string consisting of zero or more A's and ending with B. Basically, this is the simple description of this regular expression. Okay. Now, regular set, a language that can be defined by a regular expression is called regular set. Understand? So, a language which can have a regular expression, which is having a regular expression, is called a regular set. Okay? If two regular expressions, R and S, denote the same regular set, we say they are equivalent. And we can write R equal to S. Like, A or B, and B or C, basically, they are going to generate same language. So we can write that, this is R1, and this is R2. So you can say R1 and R2 are equivalent. Here are some algebraic law of regular expression where you can say where R, S, and T are three small regular expressions. So what operations can be performed among them? So you can see here, or operation is a commutative operation. So R or S or S or R are equivalent. Or if you have, this R is associative also. So if you have R or S or T, you can again write R or S in bracket, then or T. Okay, understand? And concatenation is associative. So R in bracket is T, or R is concatenated then T are same. Okay, concatenation are distributive. It can distribute over R. Like you have R in bracket S or T is given, then it can be, you know, simplified like R S or R T. Or if you have this reverse way also, S or T you have, S or T you have, and concatenation R is there, it can be written as S R or T R. Okay. Then you can see here epsilon. Epsilon is the identity for concatenation. That means if you add epsilon, it will not change the regular expression. Okay, it doesn't matter where you are adding. Okay, then R star. Okay, so here epsilon is generated in a closure as well. Okay, so this is called, this star is called Kleene closure. Okay, so R star equal to R or epsilon whole star can also be written, and this as closure operation is idempotent. Okay, that means if there is multiple R to the power star star, it is nothing but R star, similar to this. Okay, so these are the basic rule of writing the regular expressions. So I think you know, we are entering in a quite interesting part, and I should take 5 minutes break before we discuss further, because I think your brains are also getting, you know, overloaded. So don't leave the meeting. It is 11:27. After 5 minutes again we will start. So keep let you be logged in. Okay, don't leave the meeting. Okay, all right then. Are you there? Can you?